Esther 2, 5, and 6. Now, in Shushan, the palace, there was a certain Jew whose name was Mordecai, the son of Jair, the son of Shemaiah, the son of Kish, a Benjamite, who had been carried away from Jerusalem with the captivity, which had been carried away with Jeconiah, king of Judah, when Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, had carried away. Why is the Holy Spirit bringing the king in the captivity of Mordecai? What took your leader can take you. Hear me well. I didn't say it will. This is one of the equipments to be more than conquerors. Leadership is spiritual. So Mordecai was carried away with the captivity that carried his king. In the realm of the spirit, leadership is a shield. In the realm of the spirit, leadership is a door. What took your leader? I didn't say it will take you. If you listen to this teaching, you'll find out how that should not happen. What takes a father can take the children. Even medical doctors have come to agree. So they ask you things like, who in your family? Is there this history in the family? Because what takes the father can take the church, can take the son. What took the father can take the son. So what took Jeconiah took Mordecai. So that means we must get to the point where we now have a healthy understanding of who is in front of us. Listen to me. It is not an emotional decision. Who is in front of you as a leader must be placed there by God. It is an effective weapon for warfare in the life that we live in. Who is in front of you? So leadership is a shield in the spirit. So you can't joke with as a woman who becomes your husband. Let me even speak to women who are about to get married. You see that you can share everything with him but not your money. You are not wise. You have equated your money above your life. How can you submit your life to a man that you can't give your money to? When a man becomes your husband, that becomes your head. And what takes your husband can take you. So it's beyond Bruno Magli's shoes. It's beyond the cologne he wears. It's about the spirit force in him. But do you know any victory your leader enjoys, you can enjoy. I didn't say you will enjoy. It's a possibility. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber. But he that entereth by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him, not to the sheep, not to the flock, the porter openeth. Who is the him? The shepherd, the head, is the him, right? In this text. Who does the porter open things up to? When the shepherd enters, will the flock enter what he has entered?
It's a normal thing.
Very normal. It's one of your equipments to conquer. How do I know? Ask Moses. It didn't make sense. Lift your hands. They were fighting and they were winning. I'm tired. They were losing. The leader in front of them. Did you read in your Bible that God told Aaron and all to sit there? Is it God that told them? Read well. Is it God? It's not God. Okay? This your hand has to go up. You know why they did that? Let me tell you. It may not even be that they love Moses too much. They know they will die. They know that if that hand comes down, they are all dead. Some of you, they'll be attacking your leader. You'll be smiling. Let me tell you something. You can succeed cheaply if you find who God has called in front of you and just follow him. And he brought up Hadassah, that is Esther, his uncle's daughter, for she had neither father nor mother. And the maid was fair and beautiful, whom Mordecai, when her father and mother were dead, took for his own daughter. I want to let you know that this is not normal. When people die, the brothers of the persons don't really show up. When a man dies, I say, your uncle is rich, your uncle is rich. I have a shocker for you. You may never see that uncle. But this one is his uncle's. This is actually his second cousin. Am I correct? Esther is his second cousin. When they capture you as a slave, you are going into a foreign land. Please, shouldn't you be thinking how you will survive? Shouldn't you be thinking of yourself? I'm giving you next key. Because, Oga, you are not my Pekino. Let me burn you to the tent, O Israel. But see what scripture says. After he was captured on his way and he brought up Hadassah, he took Hadassah like his own. If you are going to conquer, there are some things that won't break until sacrifice comes. What Mordecai did here was sacrifice. And guess what? Do you know it was the Hadassah that he raised that took him up to the palace? It's called the law of seed. Now, listen to me. This is where the trick of the enemy is. When things are not okay, like Mordecai, things are bad, things are not turning out right, that is when you need what you have the most. But that is when God tells you, I need it. What is a sacrifice? Sacrifice is giving up what you need. Mordecai needed comfort. But here is Mordecai. What is he doing? Looking after somebody else. When it's not comfortable for you, when you should be thinking of yourself, but you are thinking of somebody else. The Bible, how many of you believe that Job needed prayer in his state? The Bible says, and Job prayed for his friends.
So he offered up what he needed. And the Bible says his captivity turned. You want something to happen in your life, God to show you mercy. Something wrong you did, you made a mistake, and God just ministers to your heart. That person owe you 160,000. Write it off. The truth of the matter is that I've seen some people, they get into some mess, they need mercy from God. I said, is there anybody owing you? Tell the person not to bother. No, pastor, for 4 years. In fact, he refused to pick my call until I used police to pick him. I said, go and tell him not to bother and watch your captivity turn. Because he that wants mercy will show mercy. The days of purification accomplished to with what? 6 months with the oil of... Stop. Bible students, what is myrrh? Is it sweet? Is medicinal? Is it for healing? Bitter things come before sweet things. How many of you have done things you've regretted? Things that you look at yourself sometimes, you're like, why was I that stupid, ignorant, wicked? You want to change it. Those are the bitter aspects of your life, right? But notice that it is also the ingredient of coming to the throne. Your ugly past, the mistakes you have made, is also part of what God needs to prepare you in the palace or for the palace. So 6 months of the oil of myrrh, okay? 6 months. Women make up and rub cream for 2 hours. None has rubbed cream for 1 month. 6 months, they were just taking the skin and massing the thing inside. If you are going to conquer, notice that your past mistakes are also ingredients for your lifting. How do I mean? Scripture says all things work together. All things means the good, the bad, and the ugly. God is in the business of using your past, sir. The bitter experiences. She's about to step to the throne, but 6 months of mashing her skin with the oil of myrrh. Why do you think you need to be perfect before God moves you forward? Now, I am not saying you live in sin, but why do you think that that past can hold you from the eternal counsel and purposes of God for your life? Oh, you are not the first to have a child out of wedlock. You should not, but if it has happened, you are not the first. God has raised giants through women like that. So that's the pains of the past, the oil of myrrh. But the next 6 months is what? The sweet what? Myrrh is bitter, right? The myrrh means the pains of the past God can still use. But before you get into the palace, God must have added sweetness in your life so that you don't walk into your next level with the pains and the hurts of the past. So that you don't walk into the palace looking like a peasant. So when people see you in your new state of glory and you tell them what you went through, they will say it's a lie. So you can't go with the oil of myrrh to enter the king's palace to see Artaxerxes. Are you getting what I'm saying? No. When you enter that palace, all King Ahasuerus will be perceiving is, some good stuff I'm seeing here. Hallelujah. You smell so nice. Hallelujah. What's your name again? But he doesn't know that underneath are some bitter experiences that you've gone through. So the oil of myrrh and sweet odors. Then thus came every maiden to the king. Whatsoever she desired was given to her. So they came and they asked all the ladies after the oil of myrrh and sweet odors. And they said, I want you to take whatever you want into the king. So they opened a treasure chest. Pick whatever you want. You should know women. Tell women to walk in and take whatever thing they want. Some were taking everything. But you know what Esther did? Esther said, I'm not taking. Wisdom precedes favor. Esther said, I'm not taking. Esther looked at the chamberlain and he said, you know this man. She didn't say that now. I will pick whatever you want me to wear. Are you getting what I'm saying? They said, pick whatever you want. She didn't pick what she wanted. She went for what she needed. Do you know that you don't really know what you need? But there's somebody who is the Holy Ghost, who is in that room, who knows what you need to get into the throne. So whilst everybody was choosing what they wanted, Esther said, it is what you wear for me. And that triggered favor. And the guy took a particular thing and gave her. And when she wore it and entered the palace, I want to speak to everyone under the sound of my voice. From today, God will open your eyes to what you need that will lead you into favor of acceptance. Whilst others are saying, I want this, I want this, I want this. You will submit your will to the Holy Spirit and he will put upon you what you need. And when you step into the palace, listen to what I'm saying, you will not be refused. In the name of Jesus Christ.